the typical place where everybody is known for being silly, you know, stupid. Yeah, actually, you saw, for example, in Portugal, where we have been, it's the people from the Alentejo, which is the region in the south. And here in Spain, it's a small town called Lepe. L-E-P-E, okay, so there's so many jokes about this place, and you can imagine, and the people there, they are used to it already, they accept it, and they don't mind. Okay, so since we joined the European Union in 1985, so we started getting involved in different competitions, things that, you know, European things. So this time they were looking for the most intelligent person in the whole European Union. Okay, so they had to pick up one from each country, a member, and then just then once they got them, so all together they would compete and see who was the most intelligent. Okay, so here in Spain, of course, they came to this little town called Lepe, looking for the most intelligent person, of course. Otherwise, we would have a joke here. Okay, so his name happened to be José, let's say, not José. Another one. Remember, he's Portuguese. Okay, so not about José. Okay, so José was the most intelligent person in a town full of stupid people, so you can imagine. He was not really the brightest mind here. But so this guy came from Brussels directly just to check, to interview José, to make him a few questions and see how clever he was. And if he was good enough, then he would take him to whatever they did, the big competition, and compete with the other ones. Okay, so of course in the town this was a huge festival here, so important. So they prepared in the square, in the main square, in the Plaza Mayor, they prepared a beautiful stage with the lights, all colorful, with the music, the band playing there. The whole town was there, all the stupid people, everybody there, watching there, supporting their friends. So the thing starts, they get there, you could see José there, all nervous with this suit. It was from his great-grandfather, you know, he inherited that suit. That was the only one he had, so he was wearing it there, looking all like a, you know, like a nerd, like this, with a couple of pens here in the pocket of the jacket, you know, like a... Okay, so the man from Brussels, he said, okay, José, hello, my name is Jacques, and I came here to see how intelligent you are. Okay, so I'm going to ask you a few questions, and if you answer them properly, so then you will go to this big competition in Europe. José was there, everybody there, come on, José, you will make it, piece of cake. Okay, so let's see, let's go for the first question here, José, an easy one here. How much is it 100 times 5? Time. José starts thinking there. 100 times 5. How many numbers here? 100 times 5. 10 minutes thinking there. All the people there, come on, come on. After 10 minutes, after 20 minutes thinking there, he goes, okay, I think I got it. 100 times 5 makes 300. The guy goes, oh my God, José, this is not correct. Is it 100 times 5 is 500? That was an easy one. I think this doesn't look good. I don't know if I'm leaving already. And of course, everybody there, no way, no way, please stay. Stay there, come on, José. Come on, give him one more chance. One more chance for José. He goes, okay, one more chance, because everybody's asking for this. Okay. Okay, José, an easier one. Let's see, how much is it? 10 plus 20. Time. José starts thinking there. 10 times 20, counting with the fingers here. Forget it. 10 times 20, half an hour thinking there. The guy was falling asleep. The other one, I got it. Okay, so how much? Okay, I think 10 times 20 makes 150. The guy goes, oh my God, I can't believe it here. This is impossible. I don't believe it. 10 times 20 is 200. José, you missed it again. Two easy ones, yes, I'm leaving. And of course, nobody was going to leave. No way, the whole stupid, all the town, all the stupids there. No way, give me one more chance. One more chance. And he goes, okay, one more. I'm going to ask you a difficult one, maybe. You are bad with the easy ones and good with the difficult ones. José, how much is the square root of 121? Time. José goes, oh, the square root of 121. What the hell is a square root? 45 minutes thinking there, he goes, I think I'm calling the square root of 121 is 9. And the guy goes, listen, forget it. That's it. Square root of 121 is 11. You missed it again. You didn't even answer one correctly. I'm leaving. Yeah, and everybody again, no way, please, one more chance. Give him one more chance. One more chance. He goes, the very last one. If you don't make this one, I come. Oh, he goes, the easiest one. I mean, even my little daughter with 1 year of age, she knows the answer. Okay, Jose, so think of it. How much is it? Take your time. Take your time. We are already doing, but keep taking your time. He goes, okay, Jose, please think. How much is it? 2 + 2. Time. And the guys go, all the stupid people watching there. Jose, last year, come on. He goes, okay, 2 + 2, 1 hour. You could see the smoke coming out from his ears. You know, the brain was burning already. 2 + 2. So after 2 hours, the guy went for dinner and came back. The interviewer, he goes, okay, I think I got it. All the stupid people there watching. Okay, I think 2 + 2 makes 4. And the whole town, one more chance. One more chance. Thank you.
Oh, sorry.
Three cheers for David.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, now we're going to get serious.
One more time.
One more time. Okay, so...